and with jewelry designers Kirti Lals, Raghu and Seema, Chiripal Jewelers Akshita Garg, and the beautiful Urvashi Rautela working for them. And we have with us Richa Singh, Managing Director from the Diamond Producers Association, and Mr. Chandok from IMG Reliance. We'd love to begin by hearing from you, Anjali, on your collection and the thoughts behind it.
Hi, I'm Anjali. So most of my collections are story-based. They're quite print-heavy, and they can be sometimes overly vivid. So I have no particular reason for having picked Jahanara, but for a book that I read called The Shadow Princess by an author called Indu Sundaresan. Personally, I'm a big fan of Mughal history, and I read a lot, but this book was a wonderful novel telling the story of Jahanara Begum, who was the eldest of Shah Jahan's children. Her mother, Mumtaz Mahal, whom we very well know, was the reason that the Taj Mahal was built in her memory. And such a magnificent monument, I didn't quite realize the magnitude of Jahanara's role in the whole thing until I came across Indu's book. And I contacted Indu a few months ago in the US, and I told her, look, I love this story and I want to design something around it. And she said, what are you going to do? It's a book. So I said, look, maybe we can tell the story of the mood of Jahanara's life as she held the empire together. She didn't get married. She fell in love. She had a child, abandoned that child, and really, quite frankly, held that empire together until the unfortunate coup that Aurangzeb orchestrated. And that was the end of that era. And I was so taken by it, I had to actually get permission from HarperCollins to use the name. And I've been back and forth with Indu. I really wish she was there for the show. But I wanted to just humbly portray just the mood of that princess and her storyline through the prints and the vibe. And I enjoy designing resort wear, so it's been fun. But I hope I've done a little bit of justice to Indu's book. And I also wanted to specially mention thank you to IMG and the Diamond Producers Association for this fantastic opportunity that we've all had to pair our clothes and designs with such fine young contemporary jewelry. And thanks, Urvashi, for walking. I appreciate it.
Thank you. Mr. Raghu, yes. Vanakkam.
Vanakkam.
Welcome to Lakme Fashion Week Summer Thank Resort you. 2019. In the Lakme Fashion Week, you have a collection, how are you feeling? Ramp, you have a beautiful jewelry, how are you feeling? So he said, you speak Tamil as well, right?
Hangin' elbow, resko sudaro, to dagdide, adur the estimation ashte.
So, his translation for the non-Tamilians in the room was when someone looks at themselves wearing beautiful jewelry and smiles, that's his inspiration for his collection, and he wants to create every piece that resonates that. So, when every woman wears any jewelry that they have created, he wants them to feel that joy, that beauty, and that pride for themselves, and that was his inspiration for his collection. Yeah?
That was pretty good.
Yeah?
That was pretty good.
Thank you. Where are the social ringla?
அதாவது இந்த உலகத்துல பார்த்தாக்கா ரொம்ப அதிகமான இன்ஸ்பயர் நிறைய இருக்கு ரொம்ப குட்டி கட்டணும் சொல்லலாம் அது மோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் தமிழ்நாட்டில் அதிகமாகவே இருக்கு சொல்ல போனாக்கா ஒவ்வொரு நாங்கள் பண்ணக்கூடிய ஒவ்வொரு டிசைன்ஸுமே நேச்சர்லேருந்து கலெக்ட் பண்ணி அதுலேருந்து டைமண்ட் ப்ரொஜெக்ட் பண்ணக்கூடிய அளவுக்கு எந்தெந்த டிசைன்ஸ் இருக்கோ அதை வந்து கன்வெர்ட் பண்ணி நாங்கள் ஜுவல்லரி வந்து மேக் பண்ணிருக்கோம்
So he says there's so much inspiration in the world for beauty, but he feels like Tamil Nadu has some of the largest inspiration for nature, and that's where he draws his inspiration for the jewelry collection. And he's looked at nature that's existing in Tamil Nadu, and he's used them to depict his collection. Correct? Okay.
Yes.
Romba Nandri.
We're very lucky to have you.
Can we hear from you too?
Sure.
Seema.
Namaskar and good afternoon to everyone. It's really very exciting to be a part of this incredible collaboration and very, very unique collaboration as well. At Kirtilal's, it's our 80th year this year, so it's quite an iconic moment where we can stop for a minute and celebrate our 80 decades in jewelry that we're really proud about. We've had four generations with us, and I think at this turning point, this makes a lot of sense because jewelry really is taking on completely new facets in our country, I think, all over the country. And I think it's expanded just people's minds on how they think about jewelry and not, you know, where they don't just think of jewelry as something they purchase before they get married, but it's become something that the woman wants to spend her first salary on a piece. And it's a matter of great pride that she can do it with her own earned money. So it's very exciting to be a brand that is primarily focusing on women, of course, and that we're able to, you know, bring out that independence and that pride in women. And so with fashion and jewelry, obviously, it's all just very complimentary. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And Akshita, we can hear from you too.
Hello, I'd like to thank Diamond Producers Association and Lakme Fashion Week for giving us this opportunity. Our brand, Akshita Garg Chirapal Jewelers, is very lucky to have a very contemporary clientele, and we are having more clients who want to wear stuff every day. And so it's something which really goes along with our brand in a sense that, so for me, I started wearing diamonds when I was 16, and being that young, finding something to wear every day was really the inspiration which started this all. And again, whenever girls like our age earlier would want to save up money and buy something, I think diamonds is one thing where you can apologetically splurge on. It's going to be there with you forever, and you can really style it with literally anything. I mean, look at the gorgeous hoops Urvashi is wearing, and it's something which she can wear with resort wear, with something like what I'm wearing, and it's something, again, which is a good investment also. So, yeah, thank you.
And Urvashi, on the beautiful jewelry and clothes you're wearing and walking at Lakme Fashion Week, how was the feeling?
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon to all the members of media. I'm extremely grateful to Lakme Fashion Week. Insta glad you came, my Maddie, and my beautiful designer, Anjali. Veranda is the brand's name. So yeah, I have to add this one special mention that right since childhood, I was always very fascinated with the Mughal Empire, with the Mughal culture, with the Taj Mahal. And in fact, last year I had a visit to Taj Mahal as well. So I've always been very fascinated and attracted towards that culture. I never thought that I'll get to wear something like, you know, a collection which is beautifully designed by designer Anjali, and it's designed. The collection theme is the Princess Jahanara, the Shadow Princess. It's very, very comfortable, and I think all of my fans or everyone, I mean, it's definitely going to be a very new look for them. I'm wearing something like this for the very first time. So yeah, I mean, I'm extremely grateful to Veranda and the jewelry designer, Akshita. She's done a fabulous job with all her regal designs. Very beautiful, young and talented. And then, yeah, Lakme Fashion Week as well. The beautiful association with the Jewelry Producers Association and the Lakme Fashion Week. I think this is something which is going to be constantly inspiring us and for the future as well. So I'm extremely grateful, and thank you everyone. Thank you, Veranda. Thank you.
Thank you so much. We all hope all your collections walk off the ramp and into someone's wardrobes very soon. Thank you.